and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit. As we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against thee and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness,
through our own deliberate fault.
We are heartily sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ, who did judge us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve thee in newness of life, to the glory of thy name.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In silence we pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who stooped to raise fallen humanity through the childbearing of blessed Mary, grant that we, who have seen your glory revealed in our human nature, and your love made perfect in our weakness, may daily be renewed in your image and conformed to the pattern of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the prophecy of Micah. You, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore, he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labour has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, my heart exalts in the Lord.
My heart exalts in the Lord.
I will sing to my God a new song. O Lord, you are great and glorious, wonderful in strength, invincible. My heart exalts in the Lord. Let all your creatures serve you, for you spoke and they were made. You sent forth your spirit and it formed them. There is none that can resist your voice. My heart exalts in the Lord. For the mountains shall be shaken to their foundations. Before your glance the rocks shall melt like wax. But to those who fear you, you show mercy. My heart exalts in the Lord. For every sacrifice is a fragrant offering, is a small thing, and burnt offerings to you is a small thing. But whoever fears the Lord is great forever. My heart exalts in the Lord.
Alleluia.
Jesus the Messiah took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means "God is with us." When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. Power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Lord God, source of our life in Christ, give you thanks for the plan of the mystery of redemption, hidden through the ages to be revealed in the fullness of time and made manifest to the world in the Word made flesh, and for the place of Mary, Virgin, daughter of Israel, in the scheme of our salvation. We pray for your church, the household of faith, that like Mary we may hear and receive your word, and give it utterance in our life together, and in our common discipleship of obedience and love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those who in their hearts reach out to Christ in faith, hope, and love, but who cannot bear his visible body, the Church, and who do not follow with us. Give us the humility to hear you speaking to us in them, and so to learn of you and to serve you and your world more effectively. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Through Mary's yes, the Son of Righteousness rose upon the world. Grant that the peoples and nations of the earth may come to walk in the light of your glory, in peace, justice and freedom. Save us from the futility of choosing violence, fanaticism and bloodshed as the way to build a better world. May Mary's gentleness help us to realize that not by might nor power is humanity saved and set free. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Give your blessing to all parents, families and homes, that our children and young people may learn to find joy in mutual service and obedience. And make your healing presence known in those homes where there is selfishness, cruelty, violence or neglect. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Be merciful to all who are afflicted and distressed, the sick in mind and body, the sad and the lonely, the hungry and the homeless. Protect all young people who have left home and all who are at risk. Give healing and salvation to all. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Remember in your kingdom all who have died. May they know the mercy promised to Abraham and to his children forever. Show us your mercy. Grant that through the prayer of Blessed Mary and of all the saints, we may indeed be made members of the heavenly family of him who is the firstborn of all creation and the firstborn from the dead, even your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
So
So we come before you now in a moment of quiet and make our own personal. Gathering up our prayers with the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. We are fellow citizens with Mary and all of the saints and of the whole household of God through Christ our Lord, who came and preached peace to those who were far off and those who were near. My brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Blessed art thou, Lord God of all creation. Through thy goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed art thou, Lord God of all creation. Through thy goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your heart. Thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
Father, you made the world and love your creation. You gave your Son Jesus Christ to be our Saviour. His dying and rising have set us free from sin and death. And now we give you thanks that your glory is revealed in the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints. In their lives, you have given us an example of faithfulness to Christ. In their holiness, we find encouragement and hope. In our communion with them, we share the unity of your kingdom. And so we gladly thank you, with saints and angels praising you and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high. Blessed is he who cometh in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. Praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord, and as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him, we plead confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory.
Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes, and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, for we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
handmaid bore the Word made flesh. We thank you that in this sacrament of our redemption, you visit us with your Holy Spirit and overshadow us by your power. Strengthen us to walk with Mary the joyful path of obedience, and so to bring forth the fruits of holiness. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
God give you grace to follow Mary and all his saints in faith, hope, and love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.